Here is another free video for the free Active Directory course. In this video, I will look at computer accounts in Active Directory. Just like a user needs a user account to access the network, every computer on the network also needs an account to access resources on the network. A computer account is required for a computer to be a member of the domain. When you first add a computer to the domain, this computer account is created. From the Active Directory point of view, it is much like a user account. Just like the user account, it has a password. Unlike a user account, the password is automatically generated. When the computer starts up and connects to the domain, it supplies its password to the domain controller and thus is allowed to be part of the domain. The password allows a secure connection between the computer and the domain to be created. In order to help keep the computer account stay secure, Active Directory will automatically change the password for the computer account every 30 days. Normally, this is a seamless process, and you will not be aware that it has occurred. If the computer is not connected to the network for more than 30 days, even if years have passed, the computer will still be allowed on the network. When the computer connects to the network again, the password will simply be changed then, since it has been greater than 30 days. It is possible for the password stored on the computer and the one stored in Active Directory to become out of sync. This can occur when a computer is duplicated using imaging products. When this occurs, the computer will not be able to access the network. In order for the computer to connect to the network again, the computer account will need to be reset and the computer added to the domain again. The computer account is automatically created in Active Directory when the computer is added to the domain, but the computer account can also be created before this. When a computer account is created beforehand, it is referred to as pre-stage. A pre-stage computer account is created for a number of different reasons. If you are using a deployment solution like Windows Deployment Services, there is an option which will allow only computers to be deployed that have been pre-staged. Since deployment solutions like this have the capability of deploying new operating systems on the network, some administrators like deployment to be controlled using pre-staged computer accounts. This ensures that before a new operating system is deployed on the network, it has gone through the correct approvals like purchasing licenses for the new operating system. This method simply gives more control over which computers are deployed using deployment systems like Windows Deployment Services. The next reason you may want to pre-stage a computer account is so that you can ensure the computer account goes into the correct organizational unit straight away. I will cover organizational units later in the course. For the present, think of them as folders for user accounts and computer accounts inside Active Directory. By pre-staging the computer account, the computer will automatically be put in the correct place, which means that group policy will be applied right away when the computer is added to the domain. If the computer account is not pre-staged like this, the group policy settings will not be applied until the computer account is moved to its correct location. Using a pre-staged computer account like this allows administrative management of a computer using group policy as soon as it is joined to the domain. If the computer account is moved after the computer is joined to the domain, the changes will not take effect until the computer is restarted, and thus there is a period of time the group policy setting will not be applied. Lastly, when a computer account is pre-staged, permissions can be assigned, allowing a non-administrator permission to add a computer to the domain. Normally, the user would require additional permissions to add the computer. For example, the user must be a domain administrator or a member of the account operators group. But using this method, you can give a regular user the right to perform this action. For example, if you had a contracted IT support person that you wanted to allow to add computers to the network, but did not want to give them additional rights to access the network, you could create pre-staged computer accounts for them. That's all the basics of how computer accounts work in Active Directory. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 domain controller to have a closer look at how computer accounts work in Active Directory. First of all, Open Active Directory users and computers from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. Next, I will expand down until I get to Computers. By default, all new computers that are added to the domain will be put under the organizational unit Computers. I will cover organizational units in more detail later in the course, so for the present, just think of them as folders inside Active Directory. You can see that there are two computer accounts in here. The first one, NYDC8, is a domain controller. When a server is promoted to a domain controller, the computer account for that domain controller will be moved to domain controllers. When I open the properties for NYDC8, notice that on the General tab for DC type, this computer account is listed as workstation or server. What has happened is this server has been added to the domain but has not yet been promoted to a domain controller. At the bottom of the screen, notice you can also add a description for the computer. This helps other administrators determine what this computer may be used for. When I open the Location tab, notice that a location for the computer can be entered. This is optional, but you may want to put the office location or building to help work out where the computer is physically located. On the Operating System tab, you can get some information about which operating system is running. This includes the version of the operating system and if any service packs are installed. On the Attribute Editor tab, you can modify the individual attributes in the computer account. If you look at these attributes, you will notice it is very similar to a user account. I would recommend, however, using the Microsoft tools to make changes to the computer account rather than make changes manually. I won't worry about going through the other tabs because they are the same as user account tabs, which I went through in the previous video. If I now exit out of here and open the properties for one of the domain controllers under Domain Controllers, notice the DC type is listed as a global catalog. If the server was just a domain controller, it would be listed as a domain controller. You can see by just looking at the properties of the computer account, you can find out a lot of useful information about the computer. I won't be covering group policy until later on in the course, but to demonstrate a point, I will now open Group Policy Management from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. Notice that under My Domain, the only organizational unit listed is Domain Controllers. This is the only one of the default organizational units in Active Directory that can have group policy applied to it. This is why you will more than likely want to move your computer accounts out of computers when they are created. If I now go back to Active Directory users and computers, I will create a new organizational unit, or OU, by right-clicking my domain and selecting New Organizational Unit. I will call this one New York. Under this OU, I will also create another one called Computers to hold the computer accounts on the New York network. I now have somewhere I can apply group policy to, but a new computer will still be put under Computers where no group policy can be applied. If you do not want to move the computer account after it is created, right-click where you want the computer account to be placed and select New Computer. All you need to do is enter in a computer name for the computer account. The name you enter will need to match the computer name of the computer that you are adding to the domain. Under this, you also have the option to set which users will be able to add a computer of this name to the domain. In this case, I will select the group Help Desk. This is a group of users that perform help desk support but do not have administrator access. I will now change to a Windows 7 computer with a fresh install of Windows 7 that I have not yet added to the domain. To add this computer to the domain, open Windows Explorer and right-click Computer and select Properties. Once inside the properties for the computer, select the option on the right-hand side, Change Settings. I have already named this computer WS2 to match the pre-stage computer account that I have already created. To add it to the domain, enter the domain name and press OK. When I am prompted for the user account, I will enter in the help desk user. The help desk user is only in the domain users group, so it would normally not have enough access to add computers to the domain. Since I created the pre-staged computer account and specified this user can add it to the domain, the help desk user will have enough access to add the computer to the domain. Once the computer has rebooted, it will now be part of the domain, and I won't need to move the computer account from the default location of computers. As stated, the computer account is like a user account in that it has a password. The password is updated automatically. If the password gets out of sync with the password on the local computer, you will not be able to connect to the domain. If I change to my domain controller, I can right-click the computer account and select the option Reset Account. Once I confirm that this is what I want to do, the password for the computer account will be reset. This should only be done if you are having problems, because once done, the computer will not be able to access the domain until it is re-added. If I now change back to my Windows 7 computer and attempt to log in using a domain account, notice that I get a message stating the trust relationship between this workstation and the primary domain failed. This is the same message you will receive if the password in the computer account and on the local computer become out of sync. To fix this, I need to log in to the computer using the local administrator account. Once logged in, I will need to open the control panel and go into System and Security, and then open System to access the system properties. Just like adding the computer to the domain, select Change Settings and then select Change. Select Workgroup and enter in a suitable workgroup name. Windows will remind you that once the computer is taken out of the domain, you will need to know a local administrator account on the computer to access the computer. If you ever take a computer out of the domain and don't know the local administrator password, I would suggest changing the password before you remove it from the domain. If you don't know a local username and password, when the computer reboots, you will not be able to log in. Once I press OK, I will be asked for a username and password for the domain with enough permissions to remove the computer from the domain. Normally, when you perform this step, the computer account for this computer will be removed from Active Directory. Since I reset the computer account will not be removed. If you were not planning on adding the computer back into the domain, you would need to go into Active Directory and remove the computer account manually. Once the computer has been removed from the domain, you will get a message asking for the computer to be restarted. Since I'm going to put the computer straight back in the domain, I don't need to perform this step. If you were planning on changing the computer name, you would need to reboot the computer first before putting it back into the domain. Once again, I will press Change and add the computer back into the ITFreeTraining.local domain. The computer will be added back to the domain using the computer account that is currently in Active Directory. This process is required to resync the password in the computer account between the domain and the local computer. That's it for computer accounts in Active Directory. In the next video, I will look at how groups work in Active Directory. Used correctly, groups make the administration of users a lot easier, particularly when you work in a large environment with a lot of users. Well, I hope you have found this video informative, and thanks for watching.